So suppose you think that I'm going to save numbers from 0 to 4. So we can have 0 to 3. So consider the number 0 to 3. So how I can store this number inside a computer? So computer cannot understand your 3 or 2. It can understand only zeros and ones. So how I can store inside the computer is I have to convert each and every digit to binary. And I have to use equal bits. So if you bought any computer, bought any laptop, you'll be specifying that my laptop is 64-bit laptop. My computer is 64-bit, 32-bit. So you are mentioning. So what is this actually? So what is this actually is, it is this data size that your system can do the calculation. So up to 64-bit means 64 ones and zeros, a bit like this, up to 64-bit can be dedicated to store one number. Here we are taking 0 to 3. So here maximum I require only 2 bits. So 2 bits are enough. So this is how these numbers will be saved in the computer. Now, if I want to save negative numbers also, what I'll be doing? So I want to store numbers from minus 3 to 3. Then how I can store it in a computer? So for that, I need some extra bit. So what you need to understand is, if the digits, let it be n, and if the digit is one digit means, we can represent only two values, 0 and 1. If we consider two digits, then 2 power 2 is 4. So we can have four different combinations, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Four combinations are possible. If I am considering three digits, 2 power 3 is 8. So 8 combinations are possible. 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1, 1. So 8 combinations are possible. If you are going to have 4 digits, then 2 power 4, 16 combinations will be there. Starting from 0, 0, 0, 0 to 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 4 ones. There will be 16 different patterns. If I am considering it 5-digit number, there will be 32 different combinations will be possible, starting from 5 zeros to 5 ones. So there will be 32 different combinations. So similarly, it can go for any power. So just a thing, now I am considering only two bits, so only four combinations are possible. So I can store only four numbers if I choose number of digits to three. If I choose my simple computer that it has a capacity of 3-bit, the original computer will be going to have 64-bit. So if you start our discussion with 64-bit, we will get confused. So I am starting with minimum number of bits. So if I am having 3 bits, I am going to have 8 different patterns. So for each pattern, one number can be allocated. So that's the thing. So here, if I choose 3 digits, I am going to have 8 patterns in which minus 3 to 3, we'll be going to have 7 numbers. So in this 8 patterns, 7 patterns can be used to store this 7 numbers. And the saving method is very easy. If you see, we know for 0, it is 00, 101, 210, 311. Now I am going to allocate the 3rd bit. So normally now, if I want to represent the signed numbers, both positive and negative numbers, this MSB is dedicated for signed bit. So I am going to use this last bit as a signed bit. So if the sign bit is 0, it indicates that these numbers are positive numbers. So if I want to know minus 1, the value for 1 is only 1. For minus 2, it is 10. So I am just taking the exact magnitude. So just convert this number to binary. Here I am going to save the third bit as 111, indicating that these three are negative numbers. So on seeing the MSB itself, we can easily understand whether this is a negative number or positive number. So this form of representation inside a computer is called as signed magnitude representation. So this representation is called signed magnitude. If you see, there are two other methods to store the negative numbers. So positive numbers will be stored as it is. There is no difference, but negative numbers can also be stored like this, which is called a signed magnitude. Or there are two other methods to store negative numbers in a computer. The second method is signed ones complement. The next method is signed twos complement. So in a computer system, most of the computers now they are using this two's complement format to store the negative numbers, because it can take the negative number as it is in the two's complement form, means it can do the subtraction easily. So normally in most of the digital systems, they are using signed two's complement form to mention the negative numbers. So let me detailly explain this. So suppose I am considering some decimal. For example, we take the same number, so 0, 1, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. So to allocate these numbers, I require 3 bits. So the first bit will be so in the signed magnitude form, what we will be doing is, we will be converting the number as it is to binary. So 0 is converted to 0, 1 is converted to 1, 2 is converted to 10, 3 is converted to 11. This is a very simple conversion from decimal to binary. Again, 1 is converted to 1, 2 is converted to 10, 3 is converted to 11. So to make the digits uniform, I will be putting 0 here. Now for the positive numbers, the third bit will be 0. For the negative numbers, third bit will be 1. So this is the signed magnitude form. If I want to represent these numbers in signed ones complement form, so let us have signed ones complement form. What I will be doing is, there will be no change in the positive numbers. So the positive numbers will be represented as it is. No change will be there. The negative number is not actually mentioned as the original magnitude. Here, it is taken as a complement of 1. So minus 1 representation will be a complement of 1. So here you take 1 and you find the complement of 1. So you'll be getting 1, 1, 0. So this is the actual 1's complement representation of 1. So I am considering 2. And I am just mentioning its ones complement, 101. So this is how a computer will save minus 1 and minus 2. So this type of saving a number is called a signed ones complement form. So for minus 3, what we will be doing is just flip the zeros and ones. That is your ones complement. So this is how a number minus 1 is stored in ones complement form. For a signed twos complement form, again there will be no change in the positive numbers. Positive numbers will be represented as it is. The representation of negative numbers is differed in each methods. So here we'll be considering the twos complement. So the twos complement of one is taken. So what is twos complement? 1's complement plus 1. So here it is 111, it is 110. That is your next number of the So in signed 2's complement form, minus 3 is stored as 101. In signed 1's complement form, the same minus 3 is stored as 100. In the signed magnitude form, minus 3 is stored as minus 111. Here, but all these three things cannot be used in a single system. Any one representation will be used in a system, and most of the system is using only signed 2's complement form. So this is mostly used in our computers, laptops. All the negative numbers will be stored as a 2's complement form. And this 2's, whenever a negative number is used for arithmetic, it will take as it is the 2's complement and it will do the addition arithmetic so that the answer will be equal, which we discussed in the previous slides.